Today, we're going to use Tinkercad's brand new sketch and twist to make a sweet pass-through fidget. So let's get cracking. Start by visiting Tinkercad.com. A few awesome things. It's a website, so it's always up to date. It's 100% free. There are no ads. And to start a design, you can simply hit Create 3D Design. I like to start by naming projects. We're going to call this Twisty Fidget. As soon as you click down here, it is saved. So to build our pass-through fidget, I'm going to bring out the cone. I'll set it in a 20 by 20 grid, and then we're going to change the parameters. I do want to highlight, if you drag these handles, it breaks the parameters, and I want to use these so that it's easy to get the exact measurements. We're going to go 14 and 60 for the height. We do want to maximize the sides so it's as smooth as can be. Now let me take you to the sketch tool. Once again, bringing this out, and we're gonna set it right here in the grid. Notice it's got a vertical line that shows it's lined up as well. If you've never seen sketch before, this is the sketch features. They show us everything that's new, awesome, all kinds of smart skills. You can check this out at your leisure. It is great to come back to. When you're done learning, you can simply click the X. If you prefer my tutorials, I've got a bit.ly to my playlist. I'll put it right here. Now let me show you the new twist and scale feature. I'm going to go 20 by 20. I'll show you why. It's just easier. Snap, 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 snap. When this is created, we can double click on it and we can edit the points. One of the cool features is you can double click again and it auto smooths. This gives us an awesome circle. My other one had a diameter of 28, so I need to change this to 28 by 28 to get it exactly the same. When we hit finish sketch, you can see that these bases are identical. The only thing different is we need to change the height to 60, and then we need to change the top scale to 0 and press enter. And bang, we have got twin shapes. I'm gonna just move this sketch cone back to the side, and let me show you how we finish this project. Once again, bring out a sketch tool, drop it down, and then we're gonna just make a part that goes almost to the outside. So notice I'm leaving 1, 2, 3 millimeters, and I'm leaving 1, 2, 3 millimeters. When I'm done, I'm gonna hit escape to finish that. I'm gonna click on that shape, and I'm gonna give it rounded ends. And I'm going to leave the stroke set at size 2. When I hit finish sketch, that piece is hiding inside there, but we're going to make it poke out. We're going to simply take the height and make it 60. And then we can move to the awesome twist and make it 90. And then instead of steps, we want that to be smooth. Bang, there is your twist shape. Now we need to have 3 of these. We're just going to do Control D. Rotate it, and then change this number to 120 and press enter. If you do Control D one more time, it saves that, and all of a sudden you've got all of the twist that quick. We're going to take one of these and do Control D and move it over. This will be the hole in a minute. I'm going to make it a hole just so it's a little bit faster. I also want to save this cone, so I'm going to do Control D and move it over really quick. Let's hide our cone so it's easier to do the next step. Now we need to grab these and do Control B to make them a bundle group. Notice they've got these awesome lines. We'll do Show to bring back our cone. And then we're going to simply grab these parts and we're going to use the awesome Intersect. Do Control I and it makes a part that when it's done, the only parts that exist are where these were touching. It does take a moment because it is complex, so make sure you're patient. But bang! There is our part. How freaking cool is that? Just for fun, I'm going to make this a different color. Let's go to this one over here. I'm going to move it a little closer. Let me show you how we finish it. I'm going to hide this again. We are going to double click on our part. And then all we do is go in here and change the stroke. So we need a gap all the way around that on the inside. I'm going to change it to 2.4. So there's 0.2 gap on each side. If your printer is not as accurate as my Bambu Labs P1S, you may want to try 2.6 or 2.8, so there's more gap around these. When we hit finish sketch, it is the same shape, but it's a little bit wider. I'm going to do the same Control D. We're going to rotate the same 120 degrees and then press Control D to make it the third time. If we do show all, grab these parts. L for align, we want to center and center. When you do control G to union group, you do need to wait because, of course, this is complex. But bang, there is your ready-to-print pass-through fidget. How cool is that? Now, of course, you can grab them, choose export, STL. I'm going to store mine in my 3D modeling folder with the name Twisty Fidget. Now I can bounce to Bambu Studio, create a brand new project. Of course, I'm going to add the file 3D modeling. There is the Twisty Fidget. All right, I'm going to choose to print this with some generic PLA I have in slot number 4. It is not black, but I'll show you the color when it finishes. We're going to use the standard 0.2 settings. If we select plate, you'll see that it's going to be under 50 minutes. How cool is that? Print plate and send it to the 3D printer. And less than 50 minutes later, a sweet Twisty Fidget. Let's go give it a test. And of course, the moment of truth. Here's our fidget. And it passes through just like that. Of course, friends, use the bit.ly above to check out all my fidget tutorials. Let's wrap up super quick. Of course, so much to learn with this tool. If you make something awesome, please add a comment down below. Also, if you haven't taken a moment, hit that subscribe button. It's absolutely free. And if you turn on the notifications, you'll be the first to know when there's a brand new video. Of course, I do want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are 3 different levels of support starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. Also, make sure you pay attention to those members only posts because you can get the most of your membership. A massive shout out as well to everybody that supports me via Patreon. We are on our way to 350 members. It has a fantastic messaging area where you can ask questions, gain skills, share designs. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time you hit that like button, hype button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.